In this video, we're going to look at what's new with Safari on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, before we get started, if you find this video helpful, stick around till the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with Safari on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. Basically, the big change is the page menu. What is the page menu? When we're looking up at the URL here, if we go over to the left, you're going to see that there's this little icon here. This is the page menu. Basically, what Apple did is they redesigned this and made tools easier to access. So we're going to take a closer look at this. Towards the end of the video, I'll also show how Apple Intelligence works with Safari by summarizing articles. All right, let's take a look at this page menu. When I tap on it, I get different options here. Now, the first option here is for find. What I'm able to do is find text within this web page. So when I tap on that, you're going to see that I get a little find dialog box down here towards the bottom, and I'm able to search. Now, this does not search the web. What it does is it searches this web page. I'm going to cancel this, and we're going to go back up to our page menu here. Of course, we can zoom in and out of our text here. And then we also have more. Now I'm going to come back to this. We're going to take a look at a few of these other options before we take a look at this here. Our next option here is hide distracting items. This is one of my favorite new features. What I'm able to do is hide distracting items on a web page. What do I mean by that? Well, let's take a look at this web page. To me, this is a distracting item. It's taken up half of the web page. I would like to remove it. I would like to hide it. To hide it, what we do is we go back up to our page menu here, and then we have to put Safari into a special mode where we can select what we want to hide. So I just tap on this. And now, all I need to do is just tap on what I want to hide. So I'm going to tap on this here. You're going to see I have a blue button there that says hide. I tap on that and watch the animation. What it's going to do is it's going to disappear. Now you can go and tap on more items if you want. When you are done, you have to leave this special mode. How do we do that? We tap on done in the upper right hand corner, and then it'll apply those changes. Where I find this to be really helpful is with Google Login. We're all seeing Google Login on more and more sites as sites embrace that. Well, maybe I don't want to log in with my Google account. I want to hide that. That's distracted items. This is how you can do it. Just go over here and then you can hide that distracting item. Now, if you want to show those distracting items again, it does just hide them. All you have to do is just go back up to the page menu, and then you're going to see a new option because you are hiding. I'm hiding something. What I'm able to do is show those hidden items again. So that's one of my favorite new features. So what else do we have? Well, we can easily turn on our content blockers, and I can translate this. And we can even customize this menu. More on that in a little bit. Below that, what I'm able to do is listen to the page. I can have the iPad read it to me. And if I want to go into reader view, I can do that as well. So I just tap on show reader. And now I'm looking at this page in my reader view. It's going to strip out all the ads. Makes it a lot easier to read. If I want to go back over to the regular web page, I just go back up to the top, I tap on this, and then I can go and hide the reader. Now, before we hide the reader, you're going to see that I also have different settings while I'm in reader view. I'm able to find something on this page. I can change the text size. I also have the more button. Again, more on that in a little bit. And then I can also change the background here. To go back to the regular page, all I do is just tap on the blue button here, and it takes me back to the regular page. There's a shortcut to get into reader view. You don't have to actually just tap on this and then tap on something else. If you long press on this, what it'll do is it'll go into reader view automatically. Now, not all pages support reader view. This is basically for articles. So you're not going to be able to use reader view on a table of contents or like on the main page of CNN or anything like that. To get back over to the web page, I long press on it again, and it takes me back to the web page. So this is the redesigned page menu. Now, let's take a closer look at this More button here. When I go over to the More button, I do have more options, of course. And this is where I can go and view the privacy report. I can hide the toolbar. I can request a mobile site because I'm on the desktop site. And then I can also print. And then below that, what we have here is different actions. So with these actions, this is where I can go and customize that page menu. I mentioned that earlier. So let's say that I use reading list quite a bit. So what I want to do is I want to add this reading list over to that front page so that I don't have to click on more. Well, to do that, we just tap on edit here. And then I just tap on the green button for reading list. And what it's going to do is it's going to add it to my favorites here. Sounds pretty simple. Where do I find these favorites now? Well, let's just go ahead and tap on done again. And I'm going to tap on done over here. Tap on it a couple of times here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to reload that page menu. And you're going to see a new option. So I tap on it. And you're going to see that I have a new option here. Add to reading list. I no longer need to tap on this more button. I can just ignore that and just go and add this to my reading list. So we can customize what is shown on this main page. Let's go back over to our More button here. In addition to that, when we go down towards the bottom, I have website settings. What are these? Well, these are specific settings for the website. So in this case here, I have it request the desktop site automatically. And I also have it go into Reader automatically, Reader View automatically. So this will only happen on CNN. So these are website-specific settings. And then from here, I can also set what the permissions are for the camera, microphone, location, as well as content blockers for the specific site. So that is the redesigned page menu. Basically, it just gives us a little easier access to all of the different tools, and we can even customize it. Now let's take a look at one more thing, and that is Apple Intelligence. I have an iPad that supports Apple Intelligence. So how does that work with Safari? Well, when you have it turned on, and I have my Apple Intelligence turned on, it's just in the settings. When we go into Reader View, so I'm looking at my page menu, and I go into Reader View. You're going to see that I have an option. You may have noticed this earlier when I went into Reader View. I have an option here to summarize. When I tap on this, what it'll do is it'll summarize this article using AI. Also, what it may do is give us a table of contents if it's a long article. So then I can click to a certain section within that article. So let's go ahead and tap on it. And right now it is reading the article. And then once it gets done reading the article, you're going to see that I have my summary here. And if it was a longer article, I would also have more information here, like with table of contents and things like that. So that's how Apple Intelligence works with Safari on the iPad with iPadOS 18. So that is what is new with Safari on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Basically, it's a redesigned page menu. They made things a little bit easier to access, and we can even customize it. In addition to that, we also have Apple Intelligence that will give us a summary of an article when it is in Reader View. So that's what's new with Safari on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you did find this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, even share it with friends and family. But even more than that, check out danstutorials.com. On YouTube, I do have over 400 videos, but on my site, danstutorials.com, I have over 2,100 videos. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have YouTube. It is a membership-based site. This is how you can help support my efforts. When you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads of the videos. You have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And you have access to my classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. This is all included with your membership to danstutorials.com. But even more than that, you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house here. I'm not part of some big organization. And your members directly affect or directly help how I make these videos. And probably most important is you're helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house here creating these videos. I'm not part of some large organization. So just know that when you do become a member, you are helping support a small business. So check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.